Okay, what's up YouTube, and welcome back to part two. Now, part one was talking about being yourself. Now, part two is basically being, do things like, if you have a goal in life and you want to achieve it, you need to show hard work. Now, me, this also goes towards me, because I am a very lazy person. I am very lazy, and I like to get rid of it. I'm trying to work on it. So this also applies to me, and it applies to you if you, this needs to go to you. Now, say like you have a goal to be a successful YouTuber, then you need to put in the work to be a successful YouTuber. Me, I want to be a successful YouTuber, so I need to put in the work to be a successful YouTuber. That's why I'm trying to get back into YouTube. The main reason why I wasn't posting YouTube videos, because like I didn't never have a quiet place. Now I got a place to be. It's quiet. I can record. Now, back to the point. If you ever have a goal, do your goal. You need to hit your goal. But if you ever have people that criticize you for your goal, back away from them. Because they don't accept, like, they don't see what your goal is. They think that your goal is a joke. Now, you don't criticize people for their joke, like their goals and stuff like that, because you know, never know, like they might actually achieve their goal. You don't criticize anyone for anything, as I said in the last video. So say like your goal is to be a famous cook, and they say, well, you can't cook, that's dumb. Back away from them, because they see that you're a joke. So yeah. But also, if your goal is starting to look more promising and you start to see that you're rising to your goal and you start to see people coming over to you saying like, we cool and stuff like that, be away, get away from them, because they don't accept your goal. They just accept your, like, you're rising. Like, they don't, they still see your goal as dumb, but they do see your fame or your wealth and stuff. They just want to be around you because you made it to your goal. That's basically all they want to do. They probably, if you want to be a famous YouTuber and you see people being around you, they gonna only see your YouTube channel as a way to get themselves more clout. Cause you got a lot of clout chasers. They do anything for clout. Like, I see literally some people post dumb stuff on Twitter just for some fucking clout. Now, I'm not a clout person. I really don't care for clout. I'm gonna get my fame one day. If I don't, I don't. If I do, I do. That's how I see it. But what I'm never going to do is dick hug one of my friends or one of the people that I care for or anybody that have a goal and they're starting to see success. I'm not going to do that. Now, you stick with the people that are loyal to you, to the people that never criticize you, never laughed at you. You stick to the people that were there for you at rock bottom, because those people, they care. They care for your goal. They see that you're going to eventually hit your goal. That's why it's always good to stick to the people that see that your goal is promising. Because if you be around the people that don't think your goal is promising, they're just a hater. And like, you shouldn't be around someone that just thinks that. Always stick towards people or around people that see that your goal can happen. And that they're not just looking for fame. They just want to see this person succeed. Me? I want to see everyone succeed. If you succeed in life, you just hit like an A plus on like a test. Because I want to see everyone succeed, like I said. Because if everyone succeeds, that'll be perfect. Now, if you don't, you don't. It's nothing wrong for not hitting your goals. But like, if you want to hit a goal, you have to put in the hard work. You have to do what you want to do. You can't just say, I want to do this and don't put in the work. Say like you want to be a chef. You have to learn how to cook. If you don't know how to cook and you want to be a famous chef, you have to learn how to cook. You have to start cooking. You can't just say you want to do this without putting in the work. And that goes for me sometimes, because sometimes I get lazy. Like I said, I want to be a successful YouTuber. So what that means, I need to put in the work. It means I need to record more. It means I have to stop being lazy on editing. I have to edit more. I have to publish more. I have to make thumbnails. I have to put in the work to do what I want to do. That goes for anything. Music, TikTok, I don't know, Instagram, I don't know, like gaming, I don't know, whatever your goal is, but you need to put in the work for it. But yeah, that's basically part two. If there's anything I missed, let me know in the comments. I don't know. I guess for part one too. But yeah, love you guys, and I'll see you all in the next video. Also, what I meant to say is, if you ever get like people like say that, well, you messed up on this or something like that, if you see it as positive feedback, take it as positive feedback, because some people don't mean to be negative. Like saying like a person says, well, your editing's bad or something like this, don't get mad and say, well, you're just a hater. Tell them, okay, what do I need to fix on? Because you may actually have bad editing. I know for a fact I have bad editing. I'm like still learning how to edit. But like, if you like ever have a goal and you like have mistakes and you ask for feedback, don't take it as people hating on you. You ask for feedback. You ask for people to tell you what are you messing up on so you can succeed better, basically. So that's all I wanted to say. That's what I meant to say, but I forgot. So yeah.